Good morning, Vandana. Today we are going to discuss about structures for discrete time systems. We are going to look into how to implement discrete time systems. An LTI system with rational system function has the property that the input and output sequences satisfy a linear constant coefficient difference equation. Systems described by linear constant coefficient difference equations can be represented by structures consisting of interconnection of the basic operations of addition, multiplication by a constant and a delay. Let us see how we are going to do this. For example, consider an LTI system with a system function as follows: h of z equals to y of z by x of z, where y of z corresponds to output, x of z corresponds to input. Impulse response for this system is as follows. This is impulse response. You can simply expand this one. B naught by 1 minus az power minus 1 plus b1 z power minus 1 by 1 minus az power minus 1 with this ROC, and if you apply inverse transform, we are going to get this impulse response. We can rewrite this in the form of difference equation, because h of z equals to y of z by x of z, and you can cross multiply them. This equals to y of z by x of z, and you can cross multiply this and this one. Then we are going to get this difference equation. Just try to recall, the inverse z transform for z power minus 1 into x of z is x of n minus 1, and the inverse transform for z power minus k into x of z is x of n minus k. Delay by k samples. Delay by k samples means we will try to multiply with z power minus k, right? This is a recursive equation. Y of n as a function of present input, past input and past output. It's a recursive expression to get output y. Here the symbols we are going to use. You can try to see this, right? If you want to implement this difference equation, we require multiplication by constants. These are the constants, right? B naught, B1, multiplication by constants. And you need some addition operations. And we require delay operations, right? X of n minus 1, delay by one sample. That means in order to implement a difference equation, or in order to implement this system function, we require three things. One is delay component, another one is multiplication by constant, and another one is addition operation, right? We are going to represent them symbolically. This corresponds to addition, x1 of n plus x2 of n, and this corresponds to multiplication by gain a, x of n into a, by some constant a, right? Ax of n. And this corresponds to delay by one sample, x of n minus 1. Because you can recollect that, right? Z power minus 1 into x of z, inverse transform is x of n minus 1. The delay by one sample. And this is a constant block diagram representation for this particular system. It's a difference equation. You can try to see this. We should get b naught x of n plus b1 x of n minus 1 plus a into y of n minus 1. Let's try to see how to get this. You can see this, right? B naught x of n plus okay, this is some other expression. Sorry for that. It's not corresponding to this one. Here we are trying to implement this particular difference equation. This is a difference equation we want to implement. B naught x of n. बी नॉट इंटू एक्स ऑफ एन प्लस ए वन इंटू वाई ऑफ एन माइनस वन, इसे आउटपुट वाई ऑफ एन, राइट? इसे इनपुट एक्स ऑफ एन, इसे आउटपुट वाई ऑफ एन. वाई ऑफ एन गॉट डिवाइड बाय वन सैंपल, जेड पावर माइनस वन इज दैट इज ए वाई ऑफ एन माइनस वन. एंड इफ यू वांट टू हैव दिस वन, डिले बाय वन मोर सैंपल, राइट? वाई ऑफ एन माइनस वन डिलेड बाय वन मोर सैंपल, जेड पावर माइनस वन, देन दिस विल बी वाई ऑफ एन माइनस टू. Now we need to add all these three terms, right? B naught x of n, a1 y of n minus 1. We need to multiply y of n minus 1 with a1. It's a multiplication operation, right? And we need to multiply y of n minus 2 with a2. Y of n minus 2 with a2. And this is an addition operation. a1 y of n minus 1 plus a2 y of n minus 2. We have covered up to this part. And after that, we need to add this one. B naught x of n. This is B naught x of n plus this term is same as sum of the two things. Then whatever we are going to get at this part is same as this thing, right? Which is equals to this y of n output. Make a note of it. We are always trying to represent with one sample delays. Each block corresponds to one sample delay, z power minus 1. See, instead of going for z power minus 2 directly for this one, we are going for cascading. You can see this one sample delay and another sample delay. The two together leads to z power minus 2. In order to get this y of n minus 2, right? And we are adding two terms at a time, not more than two. You can see this. We are adding this term and this term. Two terms we are adding. Here also we are adding this term and this term. Two terms at a time we are adding. Two terms at a time we are adding. First we are adding these two terms here. And after that we are adding this term and this term at this point. It's an implementation of this particular difference equation. Here we are trying to implement this with the help of two adder blocks and two delay elements. Two delay elements, right? In general, you can try to implement delays. Yeah, just try to recall that digital electronic circuits course. With the help of resistors, you can implement them, right? Resistors which makes use of flip-flops. With the help of resistors, you can try to have the delays. And this is multiplication, right? Some multiplication circuit should be there. Here also some multiplication circuit should be there. Some multiplication circuit should be here also. Consider higher order difference equation, the general version, right? The corresponding system function is as follows. H of z equals to y of z by x of z, which is equals to this one. Let's try to implement this particular difference equation, generalize the difference equation. Let's try to call this like V of n. This part we are calling it like V of n. We have n equals to this recursive component plus V of n, which is a function of inputs only, right? Direct form one block diagram representation of this particular difference equation. We are calling this like V of n. This part we are calling it like V of n. Here we are trying to implement this V of n first. At first we want to implement this one. After that we'll try to add this term to this one. You can see this. Once you got V of n, we'll try to add that V of n to this recursive term. This recursive term we are going to get. We'll try to add both of them, this and this, to get V of n. Let's have a look into this part, V of n. You can try to see this, right? X of n delayed by zero samples, B naught x of n plus B1 x of n minus 1 delayed by one sample, right? Plus B2 x of n minus 2 plus and so on, Bm x of n minus m. In total, we required M delays, right? We can simply go for cascading. This is an input XOR n delayed by one sample. This is XOR n minus one, delayed by one more sample, XOR n minus two, delayed by one more sample, XOR n minus three, and so on. Delayed by one more sample, XOR n minus m. Total M delays. The number of delays in this case are M, capital M number of delays in this. This is X of n, this is X of n minus m. And immediately before this one, this is X of n minus of m minus 1. Now, we need to multiply them with concerned coefficients. After that, we need to add all together. Here also, we are trying to add two at a time. Instead of adding all together, we are trying to add two at a time. In that manner, we are going in a sequential manner. Let's try to have a look into that. We want to see whether this V of n is same as this one or different. V of n equals to, you can see, x of n to b naught, b naught x of n plus, if you try to have a look into this component, this will be b1 x of n minus 1. Plus, this is adding to this one, right? Finally, plus this component is there. This component will be once again this x of n minus 2 into b2, b2 x of n minus 2 added to this one, plus and so on, bm minus 1 x of m minus 1 plus bm x of n minus m. This is the way we are going to implement. Try to think how many adders we are using here. You have a look into this. We are going for capital M number of adders here. You can try to see this. We are adding M plus 1 terms, right? K equal to 0 to M. We are trying to add capital M plus 1 number of terms. For that, we are using capital M number of adders. And the delay elements we are using here is capital M number of delay elements. And multiplication circuit should be there, right? This is one multiplier, second multiplication circuit, M minus 1. Total m plus 1 multipliers, including b naught, right? M plus 1 multiplier circuits. It means we are done with computation of this particular V of n. Now we need to add this V of n to this recursive term. Let's try to see how to implement this recursive term. This output Y of n, input is X of n, output is Y of n. And we want to implement this recursive term. You see, a1 y of n minus 1 plus a2 y of n minus 2 plus a3 y of n minus 3 and so on plus an y of n minus capital N. In total, we require capital N delays, right? Delayed by one sample. Y of n delayed by one sample. This is y of n, right? Y of n delayed by one sample means y of n minus 1. This is y of n minus 2. Y of n minus 3 and so on is y of n minus n. We required n delays, n such delays, capital N such delays. Now we need to add all of them. You see, y of n minus 1, a1 into y of n minus 1 plus a2 y of n minus 2 plus and so on, an y of n minus n. We will try to add all of them, all the terms, two at a time, right? And finally, that should be added to this V of n plus this whole recursive term, right? This is the recursive term we are getting. We'll have to add both of them, and the output after addition, this should be same as Y of n. You can see, this is Y of n, right? The output on top of this arrow is Y of n. This is y of n, this is also y of n. Output on top of this. is a direct form one implementation. Let's see, I'll look into that once again. It's a transfer function or the system function. This can be decomposed as cascading of two systems, like just denominator part into this numerator part, right? We can call this like a H2 object. We can call it like H1 of Z. V of Z equal to H1 of Z into X of Z. H1 of Z into X of Z. If you had out, let's see how we can do that. V of Z equals to this numerator part into X of Z implies that if you try to convert into time domain, V of N equals to sigma bk x of n minus k, right? Sigma bk x of n minus k. We are getting this thing, right? Which we are calling it like V of N. V of N is the output. V of N is the output of this particular subsystem. This is H1 of Z. This corresponds to H1 of Z system. This is the input X of N. This is the constant output V of N. X of Z, V of Z. This one is H1 of Z. The Z transfer domain. And after that, we are giving this V of N as an input to this second system. The second system is H2 of Z. Then the output we are going to get is Y of Z or Y of N. The second system, right? H2 of Z into V of Z. Okay, this is the input to this particular system, and the concerned output is this one, Y of Z or Y of N in time domain. On the other hand, we can represent H of Z as follows. H of Z equal to H1 of Z into H2 of Z. Because both are same, right? H equals to H2, H1 is same as H equals to H1, H2. Both are same. We are simply interchanging those two systems, H1 and H2 blocks. Because you can see this product is same as, if you interchange them, still that remains same, right? In this case, we want to implement H2 object first. We want to implement this H2 object system first. After that, we'll try to implement H1 object. Let's represent X object corresponds to input and W object corresponds to output when the system is H2 object. And after that, we'll try to apply this as input, this particular W object as an input to system with impulses with the transfer function H1 of Z. Then we are going to get this Y of Z equals to H1 of Z into W of Z. We want to implement in the reverse order. From this, you can have W of N equals to this one. If you cross multiply this one and take inverse Z transform, we'll end up with this. And Y of N corresponds to this one. First, we are trying to implement W of N, right? Our target is we want to implement W of N first. This is W of N. After that, we'll try to apply this W of N as an input to this particular system H1 of Z. It means this one corresponds to H2 of Z and this one corresponds to H1 object. Earlier we are going for the reverse way, right? H1 H2. We are implementing H1 object first. After that we are implementing H2 object. Now what we are doing is we are simply interchanging these two systems. This one we are keeping first. This one we are keeping next, right? You can compare these two figures. We're just interchanging those two blocks. If you are doing a cross check, this W of n should be equal to this one. That should be equal to x of n plus, you can see x of n plus a1 w of n minus 1 plus, this is w of n minus 2, right, into a2 w of n minus 2 plus and so on. See w of n minus n into an, which is same as this, right? W of n equals to this recursive expression. You can cross check, right? Both are same. And after that, we need to have this as final output. If you pass through system H1, sigma bk w of n minus k. You can see this, right? Y of n. B naught w of n plus, this is w of n minus 1, right? Into b1 plus w of n minus 2 into b2 and so on, w of n minus n into bn. Now it verified, right? In this scenario, we consider capital M equals to capital N just for our convenience. This sub case. If you want, you can compare this one with direct form one structure. If you call it like H1 object and if you call it like H2 object, what you did there is we simply interchange those two blocks. First, we are placing this H2 first. After that, we are keeping this H1 next. That's what we are doing here. Just interchange them, right? You can just cross check. You can try to simplify this further. Because the reason is, whatever the output we are going to get from this one is W of n minus 1. This has a W of n minus 1, right? This corresponds to W of n. The W of n minus 1, this has a W of n minus 1. W of n minus 2, this has a W of n minus 2. This is W of n minus 1, this has a W of n minus 1. Then no need to repeat this twice, right? You can simply remove one of them, either this one or this one. And you can get the output from these nodes, right? So that you can save the number of delay elements. Instead of using 2 into capital N number of delay elements, you can simply go with capital N number of delay elements for this entire block. You can save the cost, right? Cost of the circuit. You can see this. See W of N minus 1, this is W of N minus 2 and so on. W of n minus n, an W of n minus n, you see bn W of n minus n, so that you can save delay elements required. See, called as direct form 2 or canonic direct form representation. You can see that in order to implement this difference equation using direct form 1, we need m plus n plus 1 multipliers. Let's have a look into this. You can see this, right? Here you require n multipliers, a1 to an. Here you require m plus 1 multipliers, b0 to bm. Total m plus n plus 1 multipliers you require. And m plus n adders. We require m plus n adders. Can you have a look into this? We require m plus n adders and m plus n delay elements. In order to implement the difference equation using direct form to representation, we need same number of multipliers and same number of adders, but number of delay elements required is not same as this one. imagine out of m comma n, max of m comma n delay elements. An implementation with minimum number of delay elements is commonly referred to as canonic form representation. So direct form representation is called as canonic form representation. Let's have a look into example. This is the system function or the transfer function. H of z equals to y of z by x of z. And if you cross multiply them, we are going to get the difference equation. And this is the implementation of that difference equation. You can see this. Y of z by x of z equal to this one. If you cross multiply, we are going to get y of n equal to some recursive term plus x of n plus 2x of n minus 1. You can see this term, right? X of n plus x of n minus 1 into 2. Up to this, we have covered. After that, we need to implement that recursive term. The recursive term corresponds to 1.5 y of n minus 1 minus 0.9 y of n minus 2. You can see this. See y of n, right? See 1.5 y of n minus 1 plus minus 0.9 y of n minus 2. This is minus 0.9 into this is y of n minus 2. And we are adding this total thing to this one. See y of n. Direct font implementation of this one. You can simply interchange this block and this block. Just interchange them. Then we are going to get this as direct form 2 implementation. Direct form 2. Thank you.